Hi everyone, in this video we want to talk about how to work with Google Colab for Python programming language, so please stay tuned. Google Colab is a place where Google provides you in order to start your Python programming coding, and also lots of packages such as NumPy, scikit-learn, and etc. are installed on Google Colab by default, so you don't have to install them. And also we can install the packages that you want in Google Colab, and also you can use the GPU that Google Colab provides you, which you can use it for running those models, which they are computationally expensive. So this is a key benefit of Google Colab, which can be used for deep learning, machine learning, and those models, which they are computationally expensive. So first of all, you need to have a Gmail account, and also you should log into your Gmail account. So as you can see that I have logged into my Gmail account. Then you should type Google Colab in the Google, and you can see this link, the first link, colab.research.google.com. You should right click on this and open this link in a new tab. Then you can see something like this. And here you should click on this one, new notebook. So first of all, notice that this is the name of our file. So if I want to change this name, I should click on it. And I should change the name to whatever I want. For example, suppose that I want to name it Kulak, and I press enter, and you can see that the name of file has been changed. So here I can, for example, insert a text block. In order to insert a text block, for example, I want to insert a text block above this code block. So I go here, and you can see I can insert a text block or a code block. So I want to insert a text block, or let's say text cell. So I click on this. And it says double click or enter to edit. So I double click on this one, on this cell, and you can see I can read whatever I want. For example, let's say I want to type introduction to Google Colab. So you can see that this is a preview of what I have typed. And if I want to make this a header, so I can put a hash before this thing that I have written. So you can see that this is a preview and this is a header. And also if I want to make my header smaller, I can put two hash characters, and you can see that my header has been made smaller. And also you can continue and put another hash in order to make this a little bit smaller. And if I want to close this editor, I have two ways. The first way is to press the escape key on my keyboard, and you can see that our editor has been closed. The other way is to click on this icon which says close markdown editor. So if I click on this, you can see that our editor has been closed. And here I want to type a code, a very simple code. So I just simply type print, and I want to print very simple thing. For example, this is Google Colab. So I want to type Google Colab. And in order to run this code block, I have two ways. The first way is clicking this icon, which is the run icon. And also I can press control enter on my keyboard, and you can see that it starts running. Remember, the first time that it is running this code block, it takes time because it is connecting, but later you can see that it takes much less time. And maybe I want to insert a text block above this code block. In order to do so, I go here and I want to insert a text block above this code block. So we can see that I can type whatever I want. For example, suppose that I want to type printing something, because we are going to print something in the following code block. And maybe I want to have a bullet. In order to have a bullet, I should simply type a dash and a space at the beginning of the line. So you can see that we have a bullet. The other way is to type an asterisk and a space in order to have a bullet. After that, I can just press the escape key on my keyboard, or simply click on this icon. So you can see that we have added a text block above this code block. And also I want to add a text block below this code block, so I can type whatever I want. So after typing, I press the escape key on my keyboard. And then I want to insert a code block below this text block. So I go here and I click on this plus code, because I want to insert a code block. And also you can click on this button in order to create a code block. And you can click on this button in order to create a text block. And if you want to remove these two, you can simply click on this icon, the delete icon. You can see that we have removed our text block. And I want to remove this one, and you can see that it has been deleted. And suppose that I want to plot a very simple scatter plot. So I want to use the matplotlib package. So I want to import matplotlib, and you can see the auto completion of Google Colab. So for example, I want this one, I import matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. So I click on it and you can see here's the auto completion, a very good auto completion of Google Colab. And after typing my code, I can press the control enter on my keyboard in order to run this code block. And you can see that here is the output. And if I want to clear the output, I can click on this icon and you can see that our output has been cleared. So maybe I want to clear this output too. So we can click on this icon and you can see the output has been cleared. And if I want to restart and run all the codes, so I can click on this one and I click on this yes. So there it is. And if I want to clear all the outputs, I should go to edit and clear all outputs. And you can see all the outputs had been cleared. And you can see some numbers beside each code block, which denotes the running order. So if I want to restart this file, but not run all the cells, in order to do so, I can go here. So I go here and restart runtime and I press the yes one. As you know, matplotlib is not a built-in package in Python, so if you want to use it, you should install it first. But you can see that Google Colab has installed some popular packages, including matplotlib, NumPy, scikit-learn, and etc. So you can see that although matplotlib is not a built-in package in Python, but Google Colab has installed some popular packages in itself by default. But maybe you ask, how can I install a module or a library or a package? Remember these terms, I mean library, package, module are used interchangeably. Maybe you ask, how can I install a module which I want and it is not necessarily installed on Google Colab? How can I install a package that I want? In order to do so, I should insert a code block and suppose that I want to install pulp module. So I simply type an exclamation mark, then pip, and then install, and then the name of package that I want to install. For example, I want to install the pulp package. So I type exclamation mark pip install pulp. So I should run this code block and you can see I should wait for installing this pulp package. So there it is, the package has been installed and I can use it. Thank you for watching, but if you are willing to know about advanced topics on Google Colab, please let me know in the comments below. Please make sure to subscribe and click the bell next to it to be notified of every new video. Again, thank you for watching.